Here's another one.
3D printed fishing floats. I am going to make one and test it on the water. First, I will design a 3D printable model of the future float. There are many 3D modeling programs and most of them will work for this task. I'm using a program called Autodesk Fusion 360. Fusion 360 is powerful, relatively easy and free for non-commercial use. I'm making a slip bobber, also called a running float. That's why I'm making the hole through the center. I will explain what is a running float later. As you can see, it doesn't take much time to create a model of this particular float. And you can design your own float of any shape and any complexity. After I finished tweaking and was satisfied with the shape of the float, I split it in two parts. This way it will be easier to print and use a different color for each part of the float. Now I need to open the final model in the slicer. A slicer is a software that converts 3D models into instructions understandable by 3D printers. Various things can be configured here, but I only need to tell the printer that this model needs to be printed hollow with some reinforcements inside, and also set the thickness of the float's walls. After that, the file generated by the slicer can be sent to the printer and turned into a physical object. The type of the 3D printer I'm using is called a fused deposition modeling printer, or simply an FDM printer. These printers use plastics that are called filaments, and I'm going to use another spool of filament to print the second part of the float in a different color. This is how it works. The filament is fed from the spool, melted and deposited layer by layer until the whole object is built from bottom to top. Now I have both parts ready and I need to glue them together. Any type of glue that bonds to plastic will work. I'm using epoxy. This step is optional. I just wanted my float to be shiny and decided to coat it with polyurethane. I started assembly and testing after the coating was dry to the touch. The float stop goes first onto the line. In my case, the stop is just a rubber band with a bead. Then goes the float, followed by a weight and a snap. The snap will prevent all the pieces from sliding down onto the leader with the hook. This construction allows the float to slip along the line until it hits the stop. And because the stop can easily pass through rod guides, it is possible to set any distance from the hook by adjusting the stop location. The maximum depth of your rig is not limited by the length of your rod. Before going fishing, I tested the float with a few different leads to make sure that the float is appropriately weighted. And then I headed to a nearby lake to see if it actually works. I wasn't sure if I was going to catch any fish and make an interesting video of how I test this float. But on the first cast, shortly after float hit the water, I got a bite and pulled out this smallmouth bass. Yes, it is measly, but I was glad I caught it. It was a good beginning. On every next cast, a tiny bass would bite and shred the worm on the hook. I didn't have enough bait and had to move to a different spot in the hope to catch a different species. The next spot was also productive, and these bluegill were biting one after another.
Here's another one.
I came for a quick test, but I couldn't stop fishing until I ran out of worms. This project was a lot of fun, from the beginning to the end. I plan to work on similar projects and make more 3D printed fishing tackle. What do you think I should make next?